ladies. Welcome back to another Commit2Fit program. We are starting today off with lower body. Again, just to recap, we're doing a circuit style training. We'll have six stations. We'll run through it consecutively with the least amount of rest as possible. After you're done the six stations, you can rest 1 to 2 minutes between the rounds and then repeat the rounds for a total of three. So we're going to start with a surrender lunge to a single leg deadlift. So again, hip width apart is going to be your stance. I always like to give myself a wider base when I'm doing lunges just to keep with stability. So you can add weights to this if you're comfortable and when you're comfortable. But starting out, just to get the hang of it, because it is going to use your stability muscles and balance. So again, remember, nice tight core always. And we're going back into that lunge, making sure that your knee is over top of your ankle, coming down nice straight, keeping that pelvis tucked, and then back up, drive that knee forward, come down into your deadlift, back up, driving that knee forward, and back into that lunge. Again, hovering that knee just above the floor, up, drive it up, and then down, whoops, and then up, and then back into that lunge. So one more time, driving it up, and nice and slow and controlled, down, and up. Let's try the other side. So, hip width stance, lunge, up, and then down, up, and back down. So driving it up, coming into that single leg deadlift, driving it up, and then back into that lunge. So again, slow and controlled with this movement. Try to keep your balance. You're going to be working on the stability, keeping your core nice and tight. 20 on each leg. When you're comfortable and ready, try using some weights. When you're doing your deadlift, and you should be able to feel it nice down the hamstring. Again, if you're doing weights, keeping them nice and close to your body. Okay? So going to number two. Station two is over here. It's going to be a runner's lunge. So this one, there'll be two ways you can do it. You can intensify the move or bring it up to more an advanced move by adding a hop, but it is not necessary. So here, runner's lunge, we all know, is this. So we're starting position, and all we're doing is up and then down. Up. And then down, up, and down. So if I want to bring this up to a notch, I'm going to go like this, up, down, up, down. So I'm just adding that hop, or no hop. Touch the floor each time. Extend that leg straight back into that runner's lunge. Up, down, or hop. Okay, so that one, we're doing 20 on each leg. First round, second round's going to be 15 per leg, and third round will be 12. So third exercise will be our abduction machine. Sorry, adduction. So what we're doing is adding that to our body. So here, we're going to bring it out. I usually put it on the second from the last. You might have to put it on the third, depending on your range of motion. And here, getting in the machine. Sometimes half the battle, but again, here you have some support just to be able to hold on to. So you can push those legs together using those inner thighs. Nice slow movement. Hold and release. Hold and release. And you want to try to bring these in so your bottom pegs actually touch. And then release. So no momentum, nice slow and controlled, squeeze and release. So that's all. We've done this machine before. We all should be familiar with it. Station number 4 will be some step ups on the bench with some dumbbells. So over here, as you can see, there's nothing less than 10 pounds. Nobody should be using anything less than 10 pounds. And this is a slow and controlled move. No bounce, no hop, no momentum. Just slow and controlled. Step up, flat foot, totally on the bench. Other one up, and then down. Up. So the foot that you step up with will always be the first to go on and the last to come off. Up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, up, up, down, down. Nice, slow and controlled. Driving through the heel. When you come up, drive through that heel and then down. Drive through that heel and then down. When you do the reverse, you just start with the opposite, driving up and last to come off. First to go on, last to come off. And that's it. Seems pretty easy. Adding those weights is what's going to help, what's going to make it more effective. Also making sure you drive through that heel when you come up. Nice tight core. And keep your shoulders back and relaxed. So station number 5 will be side lunge with a knee raise. So right here. So this one, the key to this one, as all side lunges, when we're lunging to the side, we want to push that butt, the booty, back. We want to feel it on the outside of our glutes and our hip flexors or our hips. So when I come down here, this way, I'm pushing out and back. So the knee again doesn't track forward. I'm not doing this. I'm doing this and pushing that butt out. And then up, and then out, and up, and out, and up, and out, and up. So a nice deep lunge, and a nice high knee raise. Okay, so again, we do that side, we flip it over, and we do the other side. For this one, we're doing 20 per leg to start the first round, then we'll go to 15, and then we'll go to 12 for the third round. So last station, single leg split lunge. So it's off this stepper here. So we're doing 20 each leg, and on our last one is going to be a pulse for 10. So again, I like a wider split lunge so I have that stability. So I always try to do my lunges. You'll never see me nice and tight. I always try to be hip width apart so I have a stronger base for stability. So again, this one is just very slow and controlled, not a lot of movement. We're really using, it's a compound exercise. exercise because we're using multiple muscles, but it's also a stationary exercise because there's no hopping, no jumping, nothing like that. So again, the key here, nice tight core, making sure our pelvis is tucked under us, our knee remains over our ankle and doesn't track forward, and down, up, down, up, down, up. So we're doing 20 of these, and at our 20th one, we're coming down and we're pulsing for 10. Okay, and that's it. Then do the other side. So again, we're doing a lot of leg, obviously leg work, but we're doing a lot of lunges. We're really working on our quads, our hamstrings, and our booties. So I didn't do a lot of jumping movements because I know some of them can impact our knees. Some of us have issues. So again, I've given you the option when you can do a hop to put it in if you can, but it's not necessary. So this is your workout number one, and I will see you soon for number two and number three. Bye.